Charlotte will be the hottest real estate market in 2023. And that is coming up. So this is the newest market report from Zillow, our much loved friend at Zillow. Charlotte will be the hottest housing market in the US in 2023. Here is what they say. Charlotte will be the hottest housing market in the US this year, according to analysis from Zillow. Charlotte is in the sweet spot. It's a growing city that's popular to move to, but not too expensive for those looking to get a family-sized home. Why it matters? Following the bidding wars and high mortgage rates of 2022, the nation's housing market is expected to cool down a bit in 2023, and it definitely has. With this in mind, data shows Charlotte's real estate market will still have a prosperous year. Zillow examined factors such as home value growth, projected change in owner-occupied households, and job growth compared to new construction to determine the nation's hottest market. Number one hottest market, Charlotte, two, Cleveland, three, Pittsburgh, four, Dallas. Here is a chart. Zillow's prediction for the hottest real estate markets of 2023. Number one, Charlotte, North Carolina. The top 10 markets all boast strong forecasted home value growth, solid economic fundamentals, relatively fast moving inventory, which I'll address in a couple of minutes, and plentiful likely buyers, Zillow wrote in its report. Charlotte snagged the top spot due to two main factors: forecasted annual home price growth and potential first-time buyers. By the numbers, home prices rose 17.5% on average over the last year in Charlotte, per Zillow's data. It was a very hot year for the housing market, but even by the standards, Charlotte stands out as a place where home prices really boomed. The high number projected first home buyers in Charlotte also stuck out to Zillow, who say that these buyers are the fundamental drivers of the housing market. Charlotte ranks second with a projected 6% more homeowner households, just behind Austin. There's a lot of folks who look like they're on the cusp of becoming homeowners in Charlotte, and recent history shows they're more successful at making the leap in Charlotte than pretty much anywhere else. On the other side of the coin, San Jose, Sacramento, Minneapolis, and Denver are expected to be the coolest large home markets in 2023. And going just back from their predictions from 2022, in 2022, Charlotte ranked number five on Zillow's predictions for the hottest housing, which Tucker said came to pass. And that makes Zillow feel good about the methodology, because Charlotte was one of the hottest housing markets in 2022. Bottom line, broadly speaking, high mortgage rates will lead to a more balanced real estate market nationwide in 2022. But still, Charlotte's booming home prices and high number of likely buyers show that Charlotte is in good health. Have home values bottomed? How are the mortgage rates doing? And how is Charlotte in particular doing? Hold on, because there's more. My name is Eli Magids, and I'm a real estate advisor here in Charlotte, North Carolina, and the surrounding areas of South Carolina, specializing in luxury homes, new home construction, and custom homes. But most importantly, I am your realtor with heart. Not trying to sell you a house, but here to help you find a home and a lifestyle that you and your family are going to love. If you think that you and I are a good fit, please feel free to reach out. My contact information is down below. Have home values hit bottom? This is from Keeping Current Matters. Have home values bottomed? Whether you're already a homeowner or looking to become one, the recent headlines about home prices may leave you with more questions than answers. New stories are new stories. They're looking to get people to watch, as are a lot of YouTube realtors who are scaring the living daylights out of everybody. I'm here to talk about Charlotte in particular. I don't know about the rest of the country, but forecasters aren't calling for a free fall in prices. In fact, if you look at the latest data, there's a case to be made that the biggest portion of month-over-month price depreciation nationally may already be behind us. And even those numbers weren't significant declines on the national level. Instead of how far will they drop, the question becomes, have home values hit bottom? Let's take a look at the latest data. Here they have latest data from have home values hit bottom. They have four different reports from Case-Shiller, which is probably the most well-known, FHFA, Black Knight, and CoreLogic, and they're showing how the prices have gone down July, August, September, and October. So you can see drops based on all of these, 0.3% for Case-Shiller in July, 1.1% in August, 1% in September, and 0.5% in October. November and December are not out yet. However, you can see that there's actually a slowing in the drop from August at 1.1% to October at 0.5%. We'll see what November and December brings. These are pretty much standard across the board. The numbers are a little bit different, but you do see a decrease even in CoreLogic from 0.7 in August, which is the largest drop, to 0.1 in October. Again, November and December are going to be very important for us to see if we've actually hit bottom. So the bottom line on this is home prices month over month have depreciated for the last 4 months on record, but there's a strong case to be made that the worst may be behind us. So there you go. We may have hit the bottom. We'll see. Next 2 months of data will be important. Third article about mortgage rates. Mortgage rates this week. Mortgage demand jumps nearly 28% in 1 week as interest rates drop to the lowest point in months. Key points. Mortgage rates are at the lowest level since September, and that is bringing new demand into the mortgage market. The average contract interest rate for a 30-year fixed rate decreased from 6.23 from 6.42, and it continues to drop. It's even lower now. A couple of days ago, things are still going down. However, we still have to be careful because the Fed still says that they're going to raise interest rates. So we have to be careful. But a raise in the Federal Reserve rate doesn't necessarily translate to an increase in the mortgage rate. It's more closely tied to the 10-year bond. So an increase in interest rates by the Fed doesn't necessarily mean an increase in mortgage rates. Let's take a quick look at the rest of this. Mortgage application volume jumped nearly 28% last week compared with for the previous week. The average contract interest rate for a 30-year fixed conforming loan, which is $726,000 or less, decreased to 6.23 from 6.42. And like I said yesterday, it fell a little bit more. Rates hit a recent high of around 7.2% at the end of October, according to the MBA survey, but ended the year at 6.58. 1 year ago, though, interest rates were 3.64%. So applications for a mortgage to purchase a home rose 25% week to week, but were 35% lower than they were the same week 1 year ago. Now, this is very important. The market, however, is not seeing any surge in inventory. The number of active listings is about 21% higher than it was a year ago. However, that is mostly because homes are now sitting on the market longer with fewer sales. New listings of homes for sale are down 22% year over year. So from my perspective, let me tell you what's going on here on the ground here in Charlotte. I'm out there every single day. There is not a lot of inventory. There is very little inventory, very little good inventory. I have people who are looking for homes and we cannot find them good homes. If the house is good and in good condition and a good location and priced right, not low, but priced right, not stupidly, that house is going. Case in point, one neighborhood, two homes came up for sale, one for $1.3 million, one for $1.35 million. These homes haven't been available for sale in quite some time. They came on the market. They're in great condition. I said the neighborhood is in a great location. I have a client looking. Both those houses went under contract in 1 day. I looked at the number of showings. The number of showings were crazy, like they were 6 months ago. Someone else told me about a house that they put up for sale. First day, multiple offers. I have a client in Chicago who bought a house here in Charlotte. They put their house up in Chicago. They were nervous about putting it up. One day, multiple offers, over asking. Those who say that the real estate market is dead or is dying or is falling, that is not the case from where I'm sitting. It's not falling. No one is giving away their homes. Trust me on this one. If a home comes onto the market and it's in a good location and it's well priced and it's in good condition, that house is flying, still flying off the shelf, whether it's here, Chicago, or anywhere else. So those who are telling you that the real estate market is freezing cold and it's going to drop to nothing, they, at this point anyway, are very, very wrong. Have things slowed down? Absolutely. Have mortgage rates knocked some people out? Absolutely. Are some people waiting on the sidelines? Absolutely. But no one is putting their house up on the market. And if it's good, it is selling. So if you're a seller, great time, especially if your house is in great condition. I hope that information was helpful. Again, if you think that you and I are a good fit, feel free to reach out to me. My contact information is down below. Don't forget to subscribe. Thank you so much for watching. And until we see each other again, next time.